Hello. I'd like to talk a little bit about my secret for making dry clay soil that's very compacted in the Arizona desert into something that's very lush and green, like you'll see around me. And so my secret includes a few things. The main thing is you want the soil to maintain moisture, and you also want it to maintain organic material. And something very interesting about organic material, especially in the desert, is it's warm enough that any bacteria that's able to grow in that organic material is going to quickly break down that organic material. It's going to turn it into carbon dioxide and leave behind inorganic material, which includes sand, clay, gravel, things like that. And you'll probably see that if you're in Arizona in the backyard. You'll see a lot of that if you don't have a way to maintain the organic material in the soil. A big mistake a lot of people have is they'll use a regular lawnmower, they'll take their grass clippings, they'll remove them from the yard, throw them in the trash can, and over time, eventually their backyard gets very, very reduced down to the clay soil that it was before they started treating the soil. And so a trick that I use, you'll notice that I have three bags in my hand. I have three different types of seed that I like to use for cover crops. This is clover seed, this is dichondra, and this is alfalfa, and I'll explain why those are so important. So you'll notice if you look down, just look down here, it's okay, that's clover. All right, clover is very important. It helps the soil to convert atmospheric nitrogen into nitrates. So soluble materials that are fixed and in the ground that the plant can suck up and make into green chlorophyll, okay? You'll notice that the plants are very green, and they're green because they have sufficient nitrogen to be able to synthesize all the chlorophyll they could possibly need. And that's very important for plants to be able to not have any bottlenecks, especially when it comes to nitrogen. And so legumes such as clover, such as alfalfa, they very efficiently convert atmospheric nitrogen into soluble nitrogen that the plants can absorb through the soil. And that helps to maintain the soil. You'll notice that the soil, look over here where it's black, you'll notice that the soil is very dark. And the soil is very dark because it's very efficient, or it's rich in organic material. And in order to be rich in organic material, you have to find a way to return that organic material to the soil.
All right, so for example, you can see here I have a lot of clover. And this clover is all thriving in the direct sunlight. And you can't see the soil underneath it, but I promise you it's very dark and rich. And I have some ground covers underneath my corn here, some alfalfa, a little bit of clover, but mostly alfalfa. And it's doing the same thing, returning that nitrogen to the soil and also adding organic material as it does its life cycle, dies, and leaves behind itself. Under the grapes here, same thing. And then scattered throughout my garden, I have a lot of overgrowth. So I'm gonna show you an example of what to do. So this is some alfalfa seed that's used as microgreens. And see how I have some dirt here with a little rosemary seedling. And so if I scatter some of this alfalfa seed onto this dirt, it's eventually going to sprout up alfalfa that'll help that soil be nurtured. As you can see here, this soil is a little bit clay looking, but that alfalfa you see there has beautiful flowers, and that's encroaching into there, and that should help replenish that soil. And actually under the surface, you can't see I'm using cardboard around these little pumpkin seedlings, and that's to help hold water in. And also as the cardboard breaks down, it also returns organic material to the soil, making the soil more hydroscopic, which means it holds more water, and then everything around it is thriving. You can see the lantana there. And then I have a close-up here of a picture of alfalfa. And I love alfalfa, I love clover. They're both symbiotic plants. They return a lot of nutrients to the soil, and as they complete their life cycle, they leave behind organic material that helps the soil be hydrated and healthy. So I hope you can apply these ideas to your permaculture garden. Good luck. They're working in mine, and I'll see you next time.